motivated.
Get motivated.
Get motivated. Hip hop motivator, blowing wisdom on the mic with Sean.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to a live edition of Flow of Wisdom. I am your host, Sean Anthony. My website is flowofwisdom.com. And obviously, last week I was not live. We did a replay of the CERN series, CERN Portals and Ley Lines. And the reason being, I had some technical issues with my computer, my laptop. Basically, I had to get a new internal hard drive. So that's what the past couple of weeks have been for me, trying to restore everything that I had on my previous hard drive. And however, I did back up some very significant information and files and stuff like that on my external hard drive, which I try to practice to do that on a consistent basis. But some of the things that I do with my production, such as Adobe Audition 3.0, and for some reason the iMovie is not up on my hard drive, the new hard drive. So I'm just going with the flow, if you will. So if you wanna help out Flow of Wisdom, you know, and you have a Adobe Edition 3.0 and you're willing to share it with me or whatever, you want to just sow into Flow of Wisdom, please feel free to send me any type of software, anything that you have. I also have a PayPal account, you know, and the email is flowofwisdom@gmail.com if you want to sow in it that way. But anyway, we're not going to waste too much time. Got a lot of information I want to share. We're going to continue the series on CERN portals and ley lines, and I'm definitely going to get into some information on CERN and portals in this show. And it's some very informative information. And just very insightful as well. But before we get into that, I just want to ask a series of questions, you know, with the whole presidential race that is well underway. One must ask the question, why is it that the entire Republican Party, well, most of the Republican Party, is mostly divided against Donald Trump? What is it that the establishment does not like about him that is causing so much resistance? You know, some would say, well, he's a billionaire. You know, he's funding his own campaign and he doesn't really have to answer to anyone. What are they afraid of? You've got a house divided within the Republican structure. And first, let me preface this too by saying this. I now have a better understanding than I did several years ago about the Republican and Democratic parties. As someone shared with me, it's like two wings on the same bird. And I'm kind of paraphrasing. I may have screwed it up, but that's basically how I look at the Republican and Democratic Party. It's two separate wings of the same bird. But nonetheless, you look at what's going on in our country and the rhetoric around Donald Trump. Why is it that, you know, the media is doing, attacking his conventions, his campaign meetings, and putting twists on it? And I remember seeing a video going viral online of a black police officer who went to a Trump rally in Arizona and to find, because he wanted to see for himself, because he was hearing all the rhetoric on in the media, seeing all the stuff on social media about how people at the Trump rally are mistreating people and being racist and stuff like that. And to his surprise, it was quite contrary to what he was reading on the internet and I guess getting in the media. And he described it as such that it was people that were on the outside that were protesting at the Trump rallies that were he explained it. He said he never seen so much hatred and anger in a group of people. And he was speaking from the perspective of being in law enforcement. He said he was afraid at one point. It was like it was about to break loose. But nonetheless, I don't want to go too far into that. But I just find it interesting how social engineering is really taking place. Social engineering. And I want to thank Robert X for that word, you know, to that phrase, because that's exactly what it is. It's what's going on. You look at it on social media. Why is it that as soon as you log on to your Facebook page, there are specific articles or posts or things that will come in your timeline that triggers your emotions? It will trigger your emotions. And it'll get you riled up, and you'll want to comment, and then you want to post something on your social media site, you know, and just getting people just divided and going against each other, and just hatred and anger just coming out of people. The worst is coming out of people right now, it seems like. And it's due to social engineering. The media, they focus on points to trigger your emotions. I'll never forget, I may have shared this on my show before, a program director that I worked for at a radio station in another market, he was saying, "Sean, I don't care what you do, when you talk to the listeners, when you're on that radio, touch their emotions. I don't care if you make them laugh, if you make them happy, if you make them sad, if you make them cry, if you make them mad, just touch their emotions." And it's the same ideology, but on steroids now when it comes to this type of propaganda in the media. I'm not sure if you've heard, but there is an unusual amount of preparation going on in Cleveland, Ohio, centered around the Republican convention. Now, this is due to take place in July. And I have heard that just about every government agency is there, making their way there and planning like it's never, I mean, it's an unusual amount of preparation from what I've been told. Now, before you go on saying, "Well, Sean, it's necessary precautions due to the presidential election and the candidates and all of that," I get that, okay? But when sources from inside are coming to you saying that the level of preparation is so extreme that it causes them to pause with caution, I'd begin to pay close attention. I've heard every alphabet under the sun: FBI, CIA, Department of Homeland Security, FEMA, NSA, all of these agencies are there. State trooper, all the way down to your local law enforcement, they're going through all the necessary precautions in July at this convention in Cleveland, Ohio. Why is the heightened security at such a level that's bringing concerns to individuals that's within those organizations saying, "Wait a minute, something's going on here"? Like everything under, I'm talking about all types of just precautionary measures. You use your imagination and thinking what type of level of preparedness that's going into this city for this event that's going to take place come July. Let's just pay close attention to it. And if you work in that area in Cleveland and you're listening to the show, or you're in that area and you know of something, or you may have been privy to something, just let me know. Flowofwisdom.com is the website. The telephone number is 1-877-300-7645. And we'll definitely keep the phone lines open for that. I have insight into some very delicate information, and I'm going to be very careful on how I share this, because if I'm too specific, I'm afraid it may jeopardize my source. However, such information, some information, you just do a little research, you'll find it yourself, that will confirm some of the delegate information that I'm going to put out there. And there is currently a particular series of training that is going on in certain parts of the country as we speak. And one of the areas in particular, what I'm talking about, around, I'll just say around the area of this Republican convention in Cleveland, Ohio. This is due to take place in July. Now, on the political front, this is going to be a big deal. You know, all the other Republican candidates have dropped out. We now have Donald Trump, the last man standing, if you will. And on the Democratic side, you got Hillary Clinton and Bernie Sanders going at it. So this is going to be very interesting on how this plays out. As we get ready to go into this commercial break, stick around, because I'm going to share some of this information that I've come privy to, that I was going to share on last week's show, but I had the unfortunate mishaps with my internal hard drive. But I have all my ducks in a row to present it to you today. So stick around, and I'll get into this information about this particular series of training that's going on across the country as we speak. Toll-free number is 877-300-7645. Don't go anywhere. This is Flow of Wisdom Radio. All right, welcome back to Flow of Wisdom Radio. I am your host, Sean Anthony. The website is flowofwisdom.com. Thank you all to my affiliates that's rocking with us, and as well as people listening online at gcnlive.com. The toll-free number is 877-300-7645. Definitely, we'll get to your calls here. I want to share this information. Like I said, there's some peculiar training that's going on around the country as we speak. And look, let me just say this. I'm all for the preparation and training, you know, to our responders, our first responders, the military, the government, and all of that in order to protect us. I'm all for that. So don't get that twisted from me. But I just want to bring this information to the forefront because it, you know, if they're going to get prepared, why not we get the insight and get prepared as well, if you're not at this moment. However, the training is for radiological nuclear WMD operations. Now, I was told that this training is not open to just any and everybody. I mean, it's, I don't want to say high level, but you need security numbers, security ID, and it comes from FEMA. Now, backing that up, FEMA just updated their website on this particular information that backs up what I just said to you. The training is for radiological nuclear WMD operations. And for those that don't know, WMD, weapons of mass destruction. Now, when you type in that phrase and it comes up on the FEMA website, training radiological emergency preparedness, FEMA's radiological emergency preparedness program, in partnership with the Center for Domestic Preparedness and the Emergency Management Institute, provides training to keep responders apprised of the latest techniques and tools to respond safely. REP, which is short for radiological emergency preparedness. REP training is conducted through FEMA's REP program, or REP program, Emergency Management Institute, and the Center for Domestic Preparedness. Now, this is a pretty extensive class. It takes at least a couple of days of some of the training. Some of the things it focuses on is the review of the REP emergency plans and planning standards that addresses the public's health and safety. And it goes into a lot of depth, and I'll go into that in a little bit here. But here's something interesting that I was told also. I was told that the people conducting the training are not from Area 51. They are from the other 50 areas. Did you hear what I just said? They're not from Area 51, the people that are conducting the training. They're from the other 50 areas. So what are you saying, Sean Anthony? You mean to tell me that there's an Area 49, an Area 50, and an Area 30? Well, apparently. However, it is clear that there are facilities, governmental and military agency bases across the country that we have no knowledge of. And I'm sure that comes to no surprise. However, there are some military bases that have come to the forefront, you know, things that we didn't know that was open knowledge, if you will. But over these years, with the flow of information and knowledge due to the internet, you can find out a lot of information. With that being said, I've been told that if in the event there was a nuclear war, that, quote, nuclear war is survivable. Also stating, quote, we have the ability to neutralize it, end quote. I have some more information, guys, going to share with you. Don't go anywhere. Toll free number is 877-300-7645. I'm Sean Anthony. You're listening to Flow of Wisdom. All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for listening to Flow of Wisdom. Toll free is 1-877-300-7645. 2 Timothy 3 says this, know also that in the last days perilous times shall come. We have to be prepared for that, not only just economically, not only physically, but spiritually. If you don't have your soul right, you need to get it right now with the Creator of all things. And I mean that with all sincerity. Get your lives right, ladies and gentlemen. There was an earthquake this earlier today on the coast of Mexico. There's been reports about the San Andreas Fault on the west coast of the United States, on how it's long overdue for an earthquake. You just don't know what's going on. All of these massive tornadoes, storms that are going on across the country, floods, sinkholes, just the ground just dropping right beneath people, swallowing entire homes and communities, I mean, cars. It's crazy. We are in perilous times right now. All right, back to the topic at hand. And trust, just be patient, because we're going to get into CERN. We're going to get into some portals information and ley lines. So just bear with me. But I wanted to share some of this information about this training that's going on right now. And if you guys, if anyone is privy to this information that I'm going to share today, please feel free. Do not hesitate to call in, chime in. If you know about it, add to it. I definitely would appreciate it. But this WMD, Radiological Nuclear Responder Operations course, it's an instructor-led exercise-based mobile training, mobile training team delivered. Course trains emergency personnel to respond to radiological weapons, weapon of mass destruction incidents, while mitigating the health risks to themselves and the public. The course combines individual performance skills required for the response to a radiological WMD incident with the fundamentals of radiation, radiological health effects, and terrorist use of radiation and radiological material. Participants learn characteristics and operation of radiological instrumentation and dosimeters, radiological survey techniques, and operational considerations for the response to a radiological WMD incident. The gained knowledge and skills are reinforced with detailed drills and exercises using radioactive material. They're going to be reinforced with detailed drills, exercises using radioactive material. The course advances from basic operation of techniques to tactical employment in realistic scenarios. The course concludes with a comprehensive final evaluation exercise that encompasses all the learned individual knowledge and skills required to respond to a WMD. Some of the objectives, I'm not going to go through all of it, but some of the course objectives is going to explain how to operate on an analog radiological instrument to determine the presence and quantity of radiation, the use of meter equipment to determine the dose rate and explain why it's necessary to get a dose rate reading, use survey techniques to determine radiological hazards and to make tactical decisions, recognize possible radiological nuclear threats that could occur within the U.S. and identify who may obtain radiological nuclear material, where they may obtain such material, and the impact and consequences of such an action. Listen, I was told that training is only when either they know something is about to happen or they are about to do something. I was told a little bit more details outside of the information I'm sharing now, personally, that they're going to be training the first responders. And everything that I was told, I found it, you know, I found the source information. So, it's available if you do a little digging. Some of the audience, this is the target audience discipline. Emergency medical services and EMS, fire service, healthcare, hazardous materials, law enforcement, private sector, corporate security, and safety professionals, public works, search and rescue. All of these people are the target of this particular training course of radiological nuclear responder. Are we under that kind of threat right now? I mean, of course, it's popular. You got North Korea talking bold and showing off their nuclear capabilities. I mean, we know what's at stake here. The countries that have that type of weaponry readily available. They're also going to be training these responders on alpha rays, beta rays, gamma rays, neutrons. This is not no lightweight stuff, you know. This is not lightweight information at all. This course is going to use actual radioactive materials. It is designed and monitored so participants receive only minor radiation doses, lower than a chest X-ray or a typical round-trip airline flight across the U.S. And in order to attend a training class, which is delivered by one of the FEMA/NPD training partners, a request must be submitted to the designated U.S. Department of Homeland Security. So if you guys want this kind of training, that's the information you can get a training coordinator in your area. What do you guys think of this? What do you make of this? You know, I have not connected the dots, but I'm putting the pieces of the puzzle on the table. Like I said, I get word of one source, you know, the alarming type of preparation that's going into this Republican convention in Cleveland in July has brought attention to people on the inside. It's like, yo, this is really extreme here. How prepared are they going to get? Like, I heard like everything is going there as far as protection, security measures, if you will. 877-300-7645. So I just find that interesting, and I wanted to get that out there. Now it's out there. You guys dissect it, chew on it, and let me know your thoughts. You know, moving on to the CERN. CERN, they had a little hiccup about a week ago. They had to shut it down or go into a shutdown mode or what have you because of a little malfunction, if you will. They had to shut down the Large Hadron Collider, which was down by, check this out, a small beach marten, which is a small mammal in the weasel family. So essentially a weasel shut it down. CERN released a press release last week at around 5:30 a.m. on Friday, 29th, April 2016. A small beach marten found its way onto a large open-area electrical transformer situated above ground at CERN, causing a short circuit and cutting the power to part of the Large Hadron Collider. The concerned part of the Large Hadron Collider stopped immediately and safely. Since then, the entire machine has remained in standby mode. A weasel. A weasel shuts down part of the Large Hadron Collider. Now, I hope you guys have been following the series, part one and part two. If you have not, I suggest you to go back and listen. You can check out the archives on GCNLive.com or the YouTube channel. Just go to YouTube.com, type in Flow of Wisdom TV, and you'll find the recent uploads on the channel. This Large Hadron Collider essentially accelerates particles so fast and so strong that they collide. And they're in the search for dark matter. Now, I shared a little bit of this on the previous show. Dark matter, unlike normal matter, dark matter does not interact with the electromagnetic force. Dark energy makes up approximately 68% of the universe, and it appears to be associated with the vacuum in space. And this is according to the CERN Accelerating Science on their website. It has distributed dark energy evenly throughout the universe, not only in space, but also in time. In other words, its effect is not diluted as the universe expands. The even distribution means that dark energy does not have any local gravitational effects, but rather a global effect on the universe as a whole. This leads to a repulsive force which tends to accelerate the expansion of the universe. The rate of expansion and its acceleration can be measured by observations based on the Hubble law. These measurements, together with other scientific data, have confirmed the existence of dark energy and provide an estimate of just how much of this mysterious substance exists. They are looking for dark matter. And they define dark matter as invisible. Invisible dark matter makes up most of the universe, but we can only detect it from its gravitational effects. How amazing is that? And it goes to show you the power of thought, the power of creation, how we can create. We are creators. You know, that whole law of attraction thing. And you think of someone and then that person ends up calling you, that the power of attraction, that stuff works. We're talking about tapping into the unseen and bringing it into the seen world, spiritual and physical. We'll be right back with more. It's Flow of Wisdom Radio. Yo, my website is www.flowofwisdom.com. Got a message from Leroy in Atlanta. He says, shout out to the weasel that threw the monkey wrench into their game plan. Shout out to the weasel that threw a monkey wrench in CERN's system. Yeah, 877-300-7645, 877-300-7645. Listen, guys, coming up second hour, we're going to talk about spirit portals and energy vortexes. Don't miss that. Also, I'm going to talk about this mysterious vortex that appears over the Large Hadron Collider the particle accelerator. Did scientists create an interdimensional portal? But before we get into that, I found an interesting article talking about Big Bang Theory could be debunked by the Large Hadron Collider. Scientists at CERN could prove the controversial theory of rainbow gravity, which suggests that the universe stretches back into time infinitely with no Big Bang. This article was written by Sarah Napton. The detection of a miniature black holes by the Large Hadron Collider could prove the existence of parallel universes and show that the Big Bang did not happen, scientists believe. The particle accelerator, which will be restarted this week, has already found the Higgs boson, which is, they call it the God particle, which is thought to give mass to other particles. Now scientists at CERN in Switzerland believe they might find miniature black holes, which would reveal the existence of a parallel universe. And if the these holes are found at a certain energy, it could prove the controversial theory of rainbow gravity, which suggests that the universe stretches back into infinitely into time with no singular point where it started and no Big Bang. The theory was, I guess it was brought up by Einstein. This whole theory of general relativity, dealing with large objects and quantum mechanics. But it takes the name from the suggestion that gravity's effect on the cosmos is felt differently by varying wavelengths of light. This is pretty interesting because, and I think I may have referenced this in the first couple of episodes, they're going to mess around and figure out that God is God. And I'm not saying that all scientists or physicists are atheists. I'm not saying that at all. In fact, I've read and researched that there quite a few do believe in God. In fact, I interviewed one Dr. Herndon last year, who figured out that they were spraying these so-called chemtrails in our skies and altering the weather. Let's go to the phone lines, 877-300-7645. We have Don in Ohio who wants to talk about the nuclear topic. Don, welcome to Floor of Wisdom. How are you?
Oh, fine. How are you? How are you?
I'm doing well.
Yes. This collider thing that seems like God sent him a rat, you know, to let him know who's boss there.
He put a weasel of all things, you know, a weasel.
Right. Anytime man starts to tamper into things that God has restricted, God always stops them. Like you were talking the other day about the Tower of Babel. See, they tried to look into something they shouldn't have been looking into, so God just confused them and say, "I limit you." Mm-hmm. But in regard to the FEMA information you was giving, I have a little background. I worked in a nuclear power plant at one time. And
Don, I'm sorry to cut you off, but please hang on the line. I got to go into a commercial break. We're going to go to the news. When we come back from the break, I want to hear your whole, we'll have a lot of time, so I'll give you the floor to share your background working at a nuclear plant and tie it into the information I was dropping at the beginning of the hour. So hang on the line, Don. Don't hang up, please. Ladies and gentlemen, stick around. We'll be back 6 minutes past the top of the hour. I'm excited to hear what Don has to say. All right, we'll be right back with more on Full of Wisdom Radio. Get motivated, hip-hop motivated, blowing wisdom on the mic with Sean.